Hello guys, this is Navin Reddy. In this tutorial, we'll talk about how to swap two numbers. Now, to swap these two numbers, let's take two numbers here. We'll say int a equal to 5 and int b equal to 4. Now, what I mean by swap is, after this code, when I say print the value of a colon, so it should print the value of a, that should be 4, and then when I print the value of b, the value of b should be 5. So what I want the output as 4 and 5. Now for that, let's see how to swap. So what we'll do is we'll assign the value of b to a, that means a equal to b, and we'll assign the value of b, value of a to b. That means the value of b will come to a and the value of a will come to b. Let's try to run this. Let's see what's the output. And if I run this code, you will see the output should be, it's taking some time. Come on. So we're expecting the output as 5 and 4, right? But unfortunately, the output is 4 and 4. It's because when you assign the value of b to a, now a becomes 4, right? And here, your value of a is already 4, that means your b again becomes 4. And that's why you're getting output as 4. What I want, when you assign the value of b to a, there should be some variable which will hold this value 5, so that in future we can assign, or in the next statement we can assign the value of this value 5 to b. For that, we require something called as a temporary variable. So we'll say this variable as temp. Now, before assigning the value of b to a, we'll assign that value of a to a variable called as temp. And then, once you got the value of a into temp, you can assign the value of b into a, and then the value of b will be temp. And using this, you can swap two numbers. Let's see how it works. So we have a temp variable, which is initially it is blank, and we are assigning a value of a. That means your temp becomes it's 5. Here your a becomes the value of b, which is 4, and your b, which comes from value temp, so your b becomes 5. And yes, we have swapped the numbers. Let's run this code. The output we're expecting is 4 and 5, and the output is 4 and 5. But if you focus in this code, the amount of memory we should be using is only 4 bytes and 4 bytes, which means it comes to be 8 bytes, right? But unfortunately, we are creating one more variable just for the swapping. That means we are wasting extra memory, right? And to save this memory, instead of going for the third variable, we'll use some other logic. Now, one of the logic we have to implement is a straightforward formula. And the formula is this. It's a equal to a plus b, then a equal to b equal to a minus b, and then a equal to a minus b, which means let's run this code. Let's see how it works. So let's run this code first, and the output is 4 and 5. We are still able to swap it, right? Again, who are familiar with this example, they might be knowing what I'm talking about. But let's say how it works first. So initially, your value of a is 5 and b is 4, which means when you say the new value for a will be 9, right? And then here, your value of a is 9 now, and your value of b is still 4. That means it's b equal to a, which is 9, minus 4, and b becomes 5. In this code, your a value is 9, and b value is 5, so your a value will become 4. And you can see we have swapped the number. Now, if you can see here, we are not wasting extra any variable, and that's the advantage of using this logic. Okay, but do you think it's enough or it's sufficient to we are just able to reduce the number of bytes by 4? But if we can focus here, the binary conversion of 5 is 101, and the binary conversion of 4 is 100, which means to represent this number 5 and 4, we require only 3 bits. But during the operation, your value of I becomes, A becomes 9, which comes out to be the binary format of 9 is 1001. That means in the course of operation, your result will go from 3 bits to 4 bits. Now let's see how to reduce or how to save that 1 bit. Again, you will say, what's the big deal when you waste 1 bit? Your system has lots of software, it uses multiple processes works with multiple threads, each thread works with multiple variables, and if you waste 1 bit with one variable, you might waste MB with one software, right? So you can see, is it possible just reduce the number of bits. Now to implement that logic, what we'll do is, instead of this plus sign here, we'll use a caret sign. Now what exactly this caret means is, this sign means it is a XOR operation. Now what exactly XOR is? XOR simply means, if you have a value which is 1 and 1, the output you're expecting is 0. That means if both the values are same, it will be 0. If both the values are different, like one is 1 and second is 0, the result will be 1. That means if both are same, 0, if both are different, it's 1. How about 0 and 0? Again, they are same, so the output should be 0. How about 0 and 1? Since they are different numbers, the output will be 1. This is how XOR operation works. Okay, so just remember this logic of, let me just cut this code and so it's cut and paste. So this is the logic for XOR. Okay, now let's implement this logic here. So what is A? A is 101. So let me write here, it is 101, and let's XOR this. So XOR with a value of B, which is 100, so it is 100, and the output will be, so first value is 1 and 1, so the output will be 0. Second is 0 and 0, the output will be 0 again, and last is 1 and 0, the output will be 1, because since they are both are different, so it will be 1. Let's go here now. So your value of A is, the new value is 0,0001. This should be XORed with the value of B, which is still 100. Now if you swap, if you apply operation here, it will become, since we have 0 and 1, it will be 1. Next will be 0 and next will be 0. Last will be 1, because it is 1 and 0, so it will be 1. And let's go for last one. So it is A, which is now 001, XORed with the new value of B, which is 101. And if you write here 101, let's swap this. So it is 0 and 1, it should be 1. Next is 0 and 0, second digit is 0. And last is 1 and 1, it is again 0. If you see this number, which is B, this value is 5, and this value here, it's 4. That means we have swapped two numbers without even wasting 1 bit. And that's the advantage of using this XOR operation. So as a good programmer, efficient programmer, you have to think, how can we reduce the number of bits required for the code? So this is how you can swap two numbers. So first logic was using a temp variable. Second was using a plus minus symbol, and third one is using caret symbol. So thanks for watching, and do subscribe for further videos.